Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to Gyaanematics. As you know, your NDA 2 2018 exam is coming up next month and is scheduled on 9th of September. So this video will be very helpful for the aspirants as this video contains the previous general ability papers solution, that is NDA 1 2018. So see, it has two parts. Part A contains English and Part B contains general ability, or we can say GK. So in English we will only focus on synonyms, antonyms, idioms and phrases. So part A, starting with English and synonyms. So first question was, I do not want you to lead a life of sycophancy as you did during the foreign rule. So what does this word means? This word sycophancy basically means the an obedient behavior to gain advantage, obedient or obsequious. So here, if we see the options out of admiration, love, appreciation and flattery fits best. So the answer to it is flattery. Second question is, in India it has become easy to attack cultural artifacts these days. So the option were beacon, assault, belch and appreciate. So coming to beacon is to make a hand gesture. Assault is similar to attack, so the answer to it is assault. Then coming to belch is to emit out something like a burp. Next question is, the growth and development of the peasant movement was indissolubly linked with the national struggle for freedom. So indissolubly means strongly or firmly. So answer to it is firmly. Next is, weather conditions have been improving over the past few days. Very easy. So here what improving means is becoming better. Mending is something, mending is to repair. Amending is to, you know, to change something in paperwork, like amending the articles in constitution. Advancing is to move forward. Next is, a local court granted bail to the criminal on Thursday. So granted here can be changed by allowed. So allowed is the synonym of granted. Next question is, the judge told he would analyze the evidence and then the verdict. So deliver means to pronounce the verdict. So next question, the confusion of the interlocutor face was gratifying. So interlocutor is basically a dialogist. So the answer to it is dialogist. He spends his money lavishly. Lavishly, what lavishly means is generously. Generously is the synonym of lavishly. Next question. Question number 9th. The government's new policies will come into force from the next fiscal year. So fiscal is not calendar, not academic. It is an economical term which means financial. So fiscal is financial year, fiscal year. So, and leap year is nothing to deal with fiscal word. Next question is, abundant food was available for the soldiers in the mess. Very easy question. Abundant means plentiful. Next is antonyms, the opposite ones. So the country's economy must be geared to wartime requirements. So the opposite to geared to is unlinked to. Next is, why does fire attract insects? Attract is the antonym to attract will be repel. Next is 14th. He is very serious by temperament. So for serious, the answer to antonym to serious, the word serious will be trivial. Next is, there are few miscellaneous items to discuss in the meeting. Miscellaneous is basically synonym to heterogeneous. So the answer to it will be homogeneous, as antonym of miscellaneous is asked. So the answer to it is homogeneous. Next question is question number 13th. the party was excellent, and I would like to thank all the people concerned. Concerned, here the word concerned, the antonym to concerned will be uninvolved. Next is, due to the postal strike, the outgoing mail got delayed. Outgoing. So the answer to it will be incoming, very easy, as antonym is asked. Next question is, he had a fine ear for music. So the answer to it will be coarse. Fine, the opposite of fine is coarse. There is no likeness between him and his brother. So the answer to it will be dissimilarity. Likeness is similarity, then the opposite to likeness will be dissimilarity. Next is, cultural diversity in the working place is good for business. So the word diversity, so the antonym to the word diversity will be uniformity. Next is, the liquid was liquidated within 5 years. So liquidated basically is an economic term, and which means bankrupt or closed down. Basically it means closed down. So the answer to it will be flourishing. Next is, idioms and phrases. So the first one is, cry over spilt milk. Cry over spilt milk is like complaining about a loss in the past. Next is, cut the mustard. So cut the mustard basically means to come up to expectations. Next is, devil's advocate. So devil's advocate is to present a counter argument. Next is, don't count your chickens before the eggs have hatched. So the meaning of this idiom is, don't make plans for something that might not happen. Next is, give the benefit of doubt. Give the benefit of doubt basically means to regard someone as innocent until proven otherwise. So we basically give the benefit of doubt if we can't prove something. Next part is very important, that is GK or general awareness, part B. So part B, starting with 51st, which one of the following statements is correct? So the first one is, any energy transfer that does not involve temperature difference in some way is not heat. This is wrong. Any energy transfer always require a temperature difference. This is also wrong. On heating, the length and volume of the object remain exactly the same. This is also wrong, as volume of the object and length as well as length changes by heating it up, mostly it increases. Next is, whenever there is a temperature difference, heat is the only way of energy transfer. This is correct statement. Next question is, an object is moving with uniform acceleration A. Initial velocity is u, time is t, and after time t, its velocity becomes v. The equation of motion is given by v equals to u plus at. The velocity along y-axis, time along x-axis, the graph shall be. So if we take time here and velocity here, the graph of v equals to u plus at will be something like this. The slope of this graph will be a. This intercept will be the initial velocity, that is u. So the answer to it will be with y-intercept u. Next question is 52nd. If t is the time period of an oscillating pendulum, then which one of the following statement is not correct? So first of all, let us see what statements are. The motion repeats after time t once, only once. This is absolutely wrong, because it repeats itself after intervals of nt, which is the statement 3 c sorry. So this statement is correct. T is the least time taken, least time after which motion repeats itself. This is also correct. T remains same only for small angular displacement. This is also correct. So the right answer is A, because this statement is not correct. So the right answer is A. All statements are correct. Next is 55th.
what is the net force experienced by a bar magnet placed in uniform magnetic field? So if we place a bar magnet in a uniform magnetic field, right, so the net force will be zero. Next is, if an object moves with constant velocity, which one of the following statement is not correct? So the first statement is its motion is along a straight line. This is absolutely right, because we have given constant velocity, not constant speed. Constant velocity means its magnitude will be same, as well as its direction will also be same. So the motion will always be a straight line. Next is, its speed changes with time. This is wrong. Its speed will not change with time. So this statement B is wrong. So the answer to it will be B. Next is, its acceleration is zero, as the velocity does not change, so acceleration will be zero. This is also correct. Its displacement increases linearly with time. This is also correct. So the right answer is B. Next is 56th. Which one of the following has maximum inertia? An atom, a molecule, a rupee coin, a cricket ball. So maximum inertia will be in which mass is maximum. So cricket ball is the right answer, because mass of cricket ball as compared to other three is maximum. Next question is 57th. Which one of the following is the value of 1 kilowatt hour? So 1 kilowatt hour is basically 3.6 into 10 raised to power 6 joules. So the right answer is B. So the next question is 58th. Which one of the following statements about gravitational force is not correct? So the first statement is A, it is experienced by all bodies in the universe. This is correct. So the answer to it will not be A. B is, it is dominant force between celestial bodies. This is also correct. So answer to it will not be B. Next is, it is negligible force for atoms. This is also correct. So the answer will not be C. And obviously D will be correct, but let us discuss it. It is same for all pair of bodies in our universe. No, it is not same, because it depends upon their mass. It depends upon their masses, individual masses. It depends upon inversely to the square of distance between them. So it will not be same for every pair of bodies. It will be different for moon and sun, moon and earth, or earth and sun. So different pair will have different gravitational force. So the answer to it will be D, as this statement is wrong. Next is 61st. Which one of the following is natural phenomena based on which simple periscope work? So the periscope is like Z shape. Here we have two mirror placed at 45 degree. So whenever light comes from this side, it get reflected 90 degree, then again reflected from here. So this phenomena is basically simple reflection of light. So the answer to it is A. Next is 62nd. Which one of the following frequency ranges is sensitive to human ears? So the answer to it is very easy, 20,000 hertz. Sorry. So the answer to it is B. Next is 59th. Whether an object will float or sink in liquid depends on it basically depends on upon their density's difference. So the answer to it is C. Next is, which one of the following devices is non-ohmic? So out of rheostat is ohmic, heating coil, copper coil, these are also ohmic. Semiconductor diode is not ohmic. So the answer to it is C. All other answers are wrong. Options are wrong. Next is 63rd. The accidental touch of nettle leaves create a burning sensation. It is basically due to the formic acid present in nettle leaves. Formic acid is also present in the ants, red ants. It is formic acid is HCHO. So it in chemical name it will be methanoic acid. So the answer to it is methanoic acid or formic acid. Next is 64th, which of the following properties is true for a toothpaste? So out of A, B, C, D, it is basic. No doubt it is basic. So the answer is directly C. No need of going into other options. Next question is, which one of the following gives the highest amount of hydrogen ions? So out of basically see, first one is sodium hydroxide, NaOH. It is a base, so it will never have highest amount of hydrogen ions. Next is milk of magnesia. It is also a base. Out of lemon juice and gastric juices, lemon juice has a pH of around 2 and gastric juices has a pH of 1.5 to 3. So if we compare the lower terms, gastric juices are more acidic than lemon juices. So the answer to it will be gastric juices. Next is, which one of the following is not true for bleaching powder? It is used as a reducing agent in chemical industry. It is used for bleaching wood pulp in paper factories. This is correct. So the answer to it will not be B. It is used for disinfecting drinking water. This is also correct. It is used for bleaching linen in textile industry. This is also correct. So the right answer is it is used as reducing agent in chemical industries. So basically it is not used as a reducing agent in chemical industries. So answer to it is A. Next is 66th. Brine is an aqueous solution of, so brine is basically a solution of salt, NaCl. So the answer to it is very simple, NaCl. Next question is, which one of the following is the chemical formula of washing soda? So first one is sodium bicarbonate, NaHCO3. This is basically baking powder, so the answer to it is not A. Next is sodium carbonate. Yes, basically sodium carbonate is washing soda, but the water of crystallization present in washing soda is 5H2O or 10H2O is the basic confusion. So basically washing soda has 10 water molecules of crystallization. So the right answer is B. Next is, AIDS is caused by a virus whose genetic material is, so HIV is basically the virus, and if we see the genetic material of HIV, it is a single-stranded RNA. Always remember the fact, it is a single-stranded RNA. Next is 70th question, which one of the following is an organelle that is not found in prokaryotic cell? So basically prokaryotic cells are the cells which do not have a nucleus. Then they also do, they have a cell wall, they also have a plasma membrane, they also have ribosomes, but mitochondria is absent in prokaryotic cells. So the right answer is mitochondria, as well as nucleus is also not present in prokaryotic cells. So here mitochondria will be the right answer. Next is 73rd. Which one of the following is the correct sequence of levels of hierarchy of classifications of organism from higher to lower level? So the right answer is phylum, class, order, family, then genus. So the right answer is A. Next is 71st. Which one of the following parts of body does not take part in the process of breathing? So bronchi is basically finger-like projections in the lungs. So it is a part of breathing, not correct. Then we have Bowman's capsule. Bowman's capsule is not a part of breathing because Bowman's capsule is basically present in the kidney. It is present in the kidney and it helps in the purification of blood. So the right answer will be B, Bowman's capsule. Diaphragm is related to the process of breathing. It contracts and relax during the breathing process. Trachea is basically the windpipe. So the right answer will be Bowman's capsule. Next is 74th. Which one of the following statement about meristematic tissue in plants is correct? These are the dead tissues and form wood. This is wrong. Then next is, they provide flexibility to plant due to their thickened wall. This is also wrong. They are present in the bark of tree only. and this is also wrong. These meristematic tissues are also present in other parts of the plant. And then we have D is the right answer, that is growth occurs in plant due to the division of cells of these tissues. So this is basically the right answer. It is correct statement. Next is 72. Which one of the following statements about classification of plants is correct? Thallophytes have well differentiated body design. This is absolutely wrong. Funaria is a fungus. No, it is not a fungus. All pteridophytes are phanerogams. This is also wrong. Bryophytes are basically non-vascular organisms, non-vascular organisms. So vascular system will not be present among bryophytes. So the right answer will be D. Right answer is D. Next is, which one of the following UT has the highest female literacy rate? So according to the 2011 census, Lakshadweep is the UT which has the highest female literacy rate.
So the next is, consider the following statements about roaring 40s. So the first statement is, they are strong westerly winds found in the ocean of southern hemisphere. This is correct. The second statement says, the strong east to west air currents are caused by the combination of air being displaced from the equator towards the south pole and the earth's rotation and abundance of land masses to serve as wind breaks. All of the given statement is correct, except westerly winds are basically west to east flowing, not east to west flowing. So the statement is wrong from this part. So the right answer is one only. Next question is 77th. The doldrum is a low pressure area around equator where the prevailing wind are calm. This is correct. Chinook is a hot and dry wind that blows in winter and therefore raises the temperature in a short time. This is also correct. So the right answer is both 1 and 2. Next question is, which one of the following is the driest desert of the world? Atacama. No doubt it is Atacama. You guys have to comment, where is the location of Atacama Desert? Gobi is in China, Sahara is in Africa, Kalahari is also in Africa, I guess. Next question is 79th. Which one of the following statement about latent heat for a given substance is correct? It is fixed at a given temperature. Absolutely right. It depends upon the temperature and volume. No, it does not. It is independent of temperature and volume. This is correct. It depends on temperature but independent of volume. This is wrong. So the right answer is 1 and 3. Next question is, which one of the following statement about mass of a body is correct? It changes from one place to another. No, it does not. It is same everywhere. This is correct. It depends on its shape. This is wrong. It does not depend on its shape. It does not depend on its temperature. No, this is also wrong, because temperature, it is somewhat related to E equals to mc square, where energy mass conversion take place. So basically temperature is one of the factor which is responsible for this equation. So the right answer will be it is same everywhere. Next question is 81st. A ball balanced on a vertical rod. This is a vertical rod and a ball is balanced on it. So it is an example of, so basically it is an example of neutral equilibrium, because see, stable equilibrium, it cannot be a stable equilibrium, because if we displace this ball, it will not come back to its original place. So it is wrong. Unstable, it is not unstable, because it can be at rest if we not displace it. So it is not unstable. Perfect equilibrium, there is no term as perfect equilibrium. So the neutral equilibrium is the right answer. Next question is 82nd. Which of the following statement about a fluid at rest in a cup is correct? Pressure is same at all points in the fluid. This is wrong. Pressure is exerted on the wall. This is correct. Pressure exists everywhere in the fluid. This is also correct. So the right answer is 2 and 3 only. Next question is 84th. Which one of the following is the number of water molecules that share with two formula of CSO4 in plaster of Paris. See, focus on the word two here. If you see the formula of plaster of Paris, POP is CaSO4, and we have half molecule of water with it. So if we multiply it with 2, we have two molecule of water. So the right answer will be the right answer will be 2 into half, that is 1. So the right answer will be 1. Next is, how is carbon black obtained? Carbon black, carbon black is basically obtained when we burn hydrocarbons in very limited amount of oxygen. So the right answer will be C, by burning hydrocarbons in a limited supply of air. Next is 83rd, which one of the following devices is used to measure atmospheric pressure? No doubt it is barometer. Ammeter is an instrument used for measuring current in amperes. Potentiometer, it measures the potential difference in volts. Lactometer is a device which is used to measure the quality of milk. So lactometer is for milk. Next question is, which one of the following properties is not true for graphite? So first one is, hybridization of each carbon atom is sp3. This is wrong. So the right answer will be A. Let us see the other option also. Hybridization of each carbon atom is sp2. This is correct. Electrons are delocalized over the whole sheet of atom. This is also correct. Each layer is composed of hexagonal rings. This is also correct in regard of graphite. So the right answer will be sp3. Hybridization is not sp3, it is sp2. Next is 87th, which one of the following is the purest form of carbon? Charcoal, no. Coke, no. Carbon black, no. Fluorine. It is the purest form of carbon, as it is one of the allotropes. Carbon has allotropes, namely graphite, diamond, fullerene and graphene. Recently discovered graphene means 4 or 5 years back. Next is 90th, who among the following first discovered cell? So cell was first discovered by Robert Hooke, and Robert Brown was the scientist who discovered nucleus in it. So the right answer is Robert Hooke. About Leeuwenhoek. Leeuwenhoek is the scientist who is related with the discovery of protozoa. Next is Rudolf Virchow. He was known as the father of pathology. Pathology means field in which modern medical diagnosis and medical research is basically done. So it is casual study of diseases. So the right answer will be Robert Hooke. Next is, the poisonous nature of carbon monoxide, CO, is due to its insolubility in water, no. Ability to form a complex substance with hemoglobin. This is right. Ability to reduce metal oxide, no. Property of having one sigma bond, no. This is the right answer. Poisonous nature is due to the ability to form a complex substance with hemoglobin. Poisonous substance. Next question is 91st. Which one of the following group organism forms food chain? Very easy question. Grass, human, fish, no. Grass, goat and human. This is correct. Tree, tree cutter, tiger, absolutely wrong. Goat, cow and human, no. So the right answer is B. Next question is 89th. Which one of the following elements is needed in the human body to transfer electrical signal by nerve cells? So out of lithium, sodium, rubidium, cesium. Sodium is basically present in the nerve cells, which helps in transfer of electrical signals. Next question is, which one of the following types of tissues will have contractile proteins? So out of nervous tissue, muscle tissue, bone tissue and blood tissue. Basically contractile protein is found in connective tissues. All these are connective tissues, but muscle tissue is the tissue in which contractile proteins are present. Next question is If by an unknown accident the acid secreting cells of the stomach walls of an individual are damaged, digestion of which of the following biomolecule will be affected to a greater extent? See, proteins are basically the biomolecules which are digested in the stomach because of the acid, gastric acid. So the right answer will be protein. Lipids are basically digested by lipase, and it is basically present in the small intestine and secretion by pancreas. So lipid will not be correct. Carbohydrates, the process of digestion of carbohydrate starts in the mouth only. So the right answer will be protein. Next is, in which one of the following places headquarters of a railway zone is located? So out of Kanpur, Lucknow, Hajipur and New Jalpaiguri. Hajipur is the headquarter of a railway zone. All other three are part of these zones. Next is, which one of the following is not a tributary to Indus River? Bias, Rabi, Chenab. These all three are tributary to Indus River. Tavi is not an Indus River part. So next question is, which one among the following is the largest tiger reserve in India according to the area of core critical tiger habitat? So out of these, Nagarjuna Sagar Sri Sailam is the right answer. It also has the largest number of tigers in it. So the right answer is C. Next is 95th, which of the following statements about Indian Academy of Highway Engineers is correct? So it is a registered society. No, it is not a registered society. It is a collaborative body of both central government and state government. This is also wrong. It is a center funded academy. So the right answer is neither one and neither two. Next is 98th, which one of the following is not a coastal depositional feature? Coastal depositional feature is asked. So out of Tombolo, Sandbar, Stack and Spit. Stack is basically not coastal depositional feature. It is coastal erosional feature. So right answer will be Stack. Next question is, which of the following is our coastal erosional feature? So erosional feature is out of 1, 2, 3, 4, notch, CR, cliff, hook. Notch is also erosional feature, CR is also, cliff is also an erosional feature, hook is not an erosional feature. So the right answer is 1, 2 and 3. Next is, chemical weathering of rocks is much greater in a place with, so basically it is greater in a place which has hot and humid climate. So the right answer is B. Next question is, which one of the following statements about the refractive index of a material medium with respect to air is correct? It can either be positive or negative. No, it is always positive. It can have a zero value. No, this is also not correct. It is unity for all materials. This is also not correct because it will be unity for air only. It is always greater than one. This is correct. It is always a positive integer, not integer, it is a positive number. Next question is 101st. Which of the following statements about specific heat of a body is are correct? First one is, it depends upon mass and shape of the body. Absolutely wrong. It is independent of mass and shape of the body. This is correct. It depends only upon the temperature of the body. See, it depends upon the temperature of the body, but not only. So the third statement is also incorrect. So the right answer is 2 only. Next question is, which one of the following is an example of force of gravity of the earth acting on a vibrating pendulum bob? So force of gravity will be the restoring force in the vibrating pendulum bob. So the right answer is restoring force. Next is, which one of the following statement about magnetic field lines is not correct? They can emanate from a point. They do not cross each other. This is correct. So answer will not be B.
field lines between two poles cannot precisely straight line at the end. There are no field lines within the bar of the magnet. This is the right one. There are field lines within the bar magnet. So the right answer will be this, D. Next is 108. Which one of the following metals is used in the filaments of photoelectric cells? So basically, tungsten is not used in photoelectric cells because tungsten is basically used in old bulbs. Then we have copper. No, copper is also not used. Aluminium, no. Rubidium is the material, a metal which is used in photoelectric cells. Next question is 105. Two convex lenses with power, two diopters. Two convex lenses are placed together, 2 and 2 power. The focal length in the of the combined lens of the system will be. So basically the power, the combined power of this system will be 4. And if we do focal length is inverse of power, so the right answer will be 1/4. Here 1/4 is 0.25 meter. So the right answer is D. Next is 106. Which one of the following alkali metal has lowest melting point? So out of sodium, potassium, rubidium and cesium. Cesium is the alkali metal which has lowest melting point. And out of in the periodic table, which element has the lowest melting point? It is mercury. Next is 109th. Which of the following statement about ring of fire is correct? Ring of fire is basically present in the Pacific region, Pacific Ocean. And number first one given is, it is a zone of convergent plate boundaries. Second one is, it is an active seismic and volcanic zone. This is absolutely correct. Third one is, it is associated with the deep trench. This is also correct, and the first one is also correct. So the right answer is 1, 2, and 3. Next is, which one of the following metals is alloyed with sodium to transfer heat in a nuclear reactor? So the right answer is strontium. Next is, which one of the following Himalayan vegetation species is found between the altitudes 1800 to 2600 meters? So basically deodar is the tree which is found at this elevation. Next question is, which one of the following rivers is not a tributary of a river Kaveri? Himavati is a tributary, Arkavati is also a tributary, Amravati is also a tributary. So the right answer will be Indravati. Indravati is nothing. It is not a tributary of Kaveri. Next question is, which one of the following local wind that blows out from Siberia? So Pargat is the wind which blows out for out from Siberia. Next is, which one of the following centers is not known for iron and steel industry? So out of these four, Renukoot is related to aluminium industry. So the right answer will be Renukoot. Next is, which of the following condition is are essential for tea cultivation? First one is tropical and subtropical climate. This is correct. Heavy rainfall ranging from 150 to 250 centimeters. This is also correct. Soil should contain good amount of lime. This is not a criteria. This is not a necessary condition for the cultivation of tea. So the right answer is 1 and 2 only. Next is, Bharat Mala project is related to. So Bharat Mala project is basically related to the roads and highway connectivity. So the right answer is improving road and highway connectivity or road connectivity. Next question is, which of the following are essential prerequisites for establishing of a thermal power station? First one is availability of fossil fuels. This is correct. Proximity to a river or lake or sea. This is also correct. Good transport network. This is also correct. Proximity to an urban center. This is wrong because it is not desired, because the thermal power station will produce lot of smoke, lot of pollution. So this is not correct in regard to prerequisites. So the right answer is 1, 2 and 3. Next question is, which of the following statements about Adi Mahotsav held recently in Delhi is are correct? The theme of the festival was a celebration of the spirit of tribal culture, cuisine and commerce. This is correct. The festival was organized by Ministry of Tourism, Government of India. Wrong. This festival was basically organized by the tribal department, and I forget the exact. It is tree fed. The department was tree fed, not Ministry of Tourism, who organized this Adi Mahotsav. Next question is, the right answer is one only. Next is, light year is a unit of measurement of, very easy question, it is a unit of distance, very large distance. Next question is, which of the following statement about electromagnetic wave, sound wave and water waves are correct? So the first one is, they exhibit reflection, this is correct. They carry energy, absolutely correct. They exert pressure, this is also correct. They can travel in vacuum, no, because sound waves, they cannot travel in vacuum. So the right answer is 1, 2 and 3. Next is, thermal capacity of a body depends on the mass of the body only, mass and shape of the body only, density of the body, and mass, shape and temperature of the body. So the right answer to it will be mass, shape and temperature of the body. This is the right one. Next question is, who among the following first used the term industrial revolution in English to describe the changes that occurred in British industrial development between 1760 and 1820? So the right answer to it is Arnold Toynbee. Karl Marx is related to Marxism theory. Next question is, which of the following statement about Olympic Gauguin 1748 to 1793 is correct? She was a lady, French lady, and she declared that the nation is a union of women and men. So the right answer is D. So the next question is, who among the following built a model steam engine in 1698 called Miner's Friend to drain mines? So in 1698, Thomas Savery was the person who built a model steam engine. So the right answer is Thomas Savery. Next question is, who gifted the Badshah Nama to King George in 1799? So Nawab of Awadh was the personality who gave this Badshah Nama to King George in 1799. So the right answer is Nawab of Awadh. Next question is 126th. What is the name of the award given to meritorious men in the Mughal court in the form of robe of honor that was once worn by the emperor? So Khillat is basically the award which was given in the Mughal court. So the right answer is Khillat. Khillat or Khalat. Next question is 124th. Which one of the following statements about Renaissance humanist culture is not true? It slackened the control of religion over human life. It believed the human nature was many-sided. It was concerned with good manners. It criticized material wealth, power and glory. So the right answer is D. It criticized material wealth, power and glory. Next question is 127th. Who among the following social reformers started a society for the encouragement of widow remarriage in 1866 in Maharashtra? See, here it is not asked who first showed interest in this widow remarriage. It was Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar, obviously, but here it is asked in 1866 in Maharashtra. So it was Vishnu Shastri Pandit who was inspired by basically Jyoti Rao Phule, and he was responsible for the encouragement of widow remarriage in 1866 in Maharashtra. So the right answer is Vishnu Shastri Pandit. If this is asked who was responsible for the coming up of widow remarriage, it was Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar. Next question is, name the first major voluntary association representing primarily Indian landlord interest that was set up in Calcutta in 1851. So the right answer to it is Britain Indian Association. Next question is 129th. Who among the following introduced permanent settlement of Bengal in 1793? So permanent settlement was introduced in 1793 by Lord Cornwallis. So the right answer is A, Lord Cornwallis. Next question is 130th. Name the rebel who fought against the British in the Battle of Chinnath in the course of the 1857 revolt. So the right answer to it is Ahmadullah Shah. Ahmadullah Shah was a ruler who was battling in the Battle of Chinnath against the British in 1857. Next question is, who among the following are two civil servants who assisted the Constituent Assembly in framing the Constitution of India? So the right answer to it is two civil servants are asked. So B.N. Rao and S.N. Mukherjee were two civil servants who assisted the Constituent Assembly. Next question is, so the right answer is C. Next question is 132. Which member of the Constituent Assembly proposed the resolution that the national flag of India be the horizontal tricolor of saffron, white and dark green in equal proportion with a wheel in navy blue at the center? So it was basically proposed by Jawaharlal Nehru. Next question is 133rd. Which of the following is not correct? Not historical, biographies. So Harshcharita was a biography. Vikram Kadeva Charita is also a biography. Pithvi Viraja Vijaya, it is also a biography. Deepavamsa is basically related to Sri Lankan text. So it is not a biography. So the right answer is one only. Next question is, which of the following pairs are correctly matched? So first one is Marco Polo. This is correctly matched with Italy. Ibn Battuta, Morocco. This is also correctly matched. Nitikan, Russia. This is also correct. And Saidi Ali Reis. This is also correctly matched. So the right answer is 1, 2, 3, 4. Next question is, who among the following was the author of Humayun Nama? Humayun Nama is basically written by Gulbadan Begum. So the right answer is C. So 137th, which one of the following about parliament is not correct? Parliament consists of President, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. This is correct. There are no nominated member in Lok Sabha. This is wrong. And so the right answer will be B, because there are two Anglo-Indians who are nominated. C is the Rajya Sabha cannot be dissolved. This is the right statement. Some members of Rajya Sabha are nominated by the president. This is also right. 12 members are basically appointed by the president, and these are from various fields like literature, art, arts, science, etc. Next question is, which of the following clans are included in Agnikul Rajputs? So out of Pratiharas, Chalukyas, Paramaras, Chamnas, all four are included in Agnikul Rajput. So the right answer is 1, 2, 3, 4. Next question is, which of the following statements with regard to the Comptroller and Auditor General CAG of India is not correct? He is appointed by President of India. This is correct. He can be removed from office in the same way as the Judge of Supreme Court of India. This is also correct. The CAG is eligible for further office under the Government of India after he has ceased to hold his office. This is a wrong statement, and so the right answer will be C. Next is, salary of CAG is charged upon the Consolidated Fund of India. This is also correct. So the right answer is C. Next is, the superintendent's direction and control of election in India is vested in. So basically the superintendence is vested by the Election Commission of India, EC of India. So the right answer is C. Next question is 142. Who among the following recently became the first woman Navy pilot? Woman pilot in Indian Navy. So basically it was Shubhangi Swaroop, who is the first woman pilot in Indian Navy. So right answer is D. Next question is 143. Which of the following provisions of Constitution of India became effective from 26 November 1949 only? If you remember, our Constitution of India was enforced in 26th January 1950. So here it is asked that which of the following provisions are became effective from 26 November 1949 only. So elections and citizenship, these two are basically the provisions which were effective from the when effective from the date when this constitution was made, fully made. So the right answer is 1 and 2 only. 143. Who among the following Indians did not hold the title of Miss World? So Rita Faria, she was Miss World. Diana Haddon, she was also Miss World. Then Yukta Mukhi, she was Miss World. Sushmita Sen was basically Miss Universe, not Miss World. So the right answer will be Sushmita Sen. Next question is, which one of the following countries have failed to qualify for the first time in 60 years for the FIFA World Cup to be held in Russia in the year 2018? So first of all, FIFA World Cup are over now. So you guys have to comment who was the winner of FIFA World Cup 2018. And for time being, the answer to 144th is Italy. Italy couldn't even qualify for FIFA World Cup. Next question is 141st. Which of the following statement regarding construction of Rohtang tunnel is not correct? First one is, it is located at an altitude of 5000 feet. This is wrong because it is located at 3100 meter altitude, approximately equal to 10,000 feet. So it is given half of it, so it is wrong. The right answer will be A. Next is, it will provide all air connectivity to Lahore and Spiti Valley. This is correct statement. The tunnel is being built by the Border Roads Organization, BRO. This is also correct. Then it will reduce the length of Leh Manali highway by approximately 50 kilometers. This is also correct. So right answer to it will be, it is located at the altitude of 5000 feet. A is the correct one. So next question is 145th. The Defense Technology and Trade Initiative, DTTI, is a forum for dialogue on defense partnership between India and. So it is basically DTTI is basically the deal in between India and US. Next is, as per the policy applicable in 2017, how much FDI is permitted in the defense sector in India? So in 2017 it was announced that now 49% can be in the form of foreign direct investment FDI. So the right answer is A, 49%. Next question is, in order to review the Income Tax Act 1961 and to draft a new direct tax law in consonance with economic needs of the country, the Government of India in November 2017 has constituted a task force. Who among the following is made the convener of it? So out of A, B, C, D, Shri Arvind Modi, he was the convener of this committee. So the right answer is Arvind Modi. Next is 147th. Which of the following countries did not participate in the 21st edition of Exercise Malabar? US, it was the part of Exercise Malabar. Japan was also part. India was also the part of Malabar. Australia was not included in Exercise Malabar. The entry was rejected, and so this is the right one. So the right answer is Australia. You guys have to comment in which sea Exercise Malabar took place. whether it is it was Bay of Bengal or it was Arabian Sea. You guys have to comment in the comment section in which sea exercise Malabar took place. Next is 148th. Justice Dalbir Bhandari of India was recently re-elected to the International Court of Justice after Christopher Greenwood pulled out before 12th round of voting. Christopher Greenwood was a nominee of, see, Christopher Greenwood was basically an English person. He was from Britain. So the right answer is C, Britain. Next is last question. The fifth global conference on cyberspace was held in New Delhi in November 2017. Which of the following statements about GCCS is are correct? The fourth version of GCCS was held in London. Absolutely wrong. It was held in India, in New Delhi. The main theme of GCCS 2017, Cyber for All, a secure and inclusive cyberspace for sustainable development. This is correct. So the right answer will be two only. No, it is not two only, because third statement is Bindu is the logo of GCCS 2017. So the right answer is two and three only. So this is the end of the video. If you really like the content of this video, please hit the like button. If you feel that this video can help someone, some of your friends, please share it with them on Facebook, WhatsApp, whatsoever you want to share. Meanwhile, you can also comment if you have any query, doubt, or suggestion. These are most welcome. You can comment it down in the comment section. Moreover, please subscribe the channel as it really motivates me to upload such kind of videos. And wish you luck for your upcoming exam NDA 2 2018. And that's it. Thank you. Jai Hind.